cracking. Welcome back, everybody, to Game 2 of Evil Geniuses versus Power Rangers in the Dota 2 Champions League Season 3 semifinals. Let's go ahead and get into it, shall we? Getting into Game 2, Evil Geniuses. Well, this is already going to be interesting, so I got to bring in my co-caster to talk about this. Real Burrow is going to be joining me once again on the mic.
Sup, sup, sup. Did you get any food in the break?
No.
Starve to death.
Oh my goodness. So I currently have had 2 chocolate donuts in the beginning of the day and 2 carrot, baby carrots.
Wow. Not even big enough to fit through the holes.
Who needs... What?
Huh?
Oh, the chocolate donut.
Yeah. You're so out of it.
I'm like, what? Is that a euphemism for something? You're saying I have a small dick, real? Is that what you're saying?
No, right. I was just thinking you could have some healthy for once in your life, you know? A donut, carrot,
for once in your life. I like how you're, like, insulting me for being a fatty who never eats. Thank you, real. With your contradictory insults. Let's talk about this game, though, because we have something interesting to get into. Evil Geniuses, they pick up the Lycan Wisp as their 1-2, while Power Rangers grab the Tree and Protector Ember Spirit. So the return of the Ember Spirit into the meta. We saw him in a couple of Southeast Asian games, and we are now going to see him here with Power Rangers picking him up fairly early on. Why do you think that is?
Not exactly sure. Ember Spirit's good, but he takes a long time to build up, and he can get punished really heavily now. Mm-hmm. And they found a lot of ways just to counter him. I think Ember Spirit mid, Panda counters him, OD counters him. A lot of heroes can do really well, and him in the safe lane isn't all that great because you're not getting all that solo EXP, which you need. Right. Ember Spirit's lacking the levels. That's the biggest problem. So maybe if they have a tree protecting him either in the safe lane or in the mid lane might work out for them, because right now EG, they love playing Lycan, and they normally give it to RTZ middle. Or Mason can play it as well. So Mason can play mid too, so it doesn't matter really where they go. As long as they have their wisps, they seem to be in their comfort zone. I'm surprised they didn't ban it out this time.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised too. The Wisp just being so versatile. I mean, at least they got the Tree Protector in their hands this time around. Disruptor and Gyrocopter is now going to be the pickup here from Power Rangers. So they're going to use the 2 holding abilities, Tree Protector and his Overgrowth, as well as Ember Spirit Searing Chains, to be able to set themselves up with easy kinetic fields into Static Storm combos, or even the Gyrocopter Ultimate coming in. As the icing on the cake. So they do have some pretty potent AoE abilities, and they also have some decent late game, but I'm still concerned that the very, very squishy carries, like Ember Spirit and Gyrocopter, both wilter under direct fire. So having Lycan and being able to lay down some physical damage, if he gets the opportunity on either one of those heroes, he can gobble them up. The Puck as well, early on with those kind of rotations, he's going to be a good shutdown hero up against the Ember Spirit with his AoE silence.
Yeah, I don't know if EG are going to get away with Puck offlane on the Dire side this time around. I mean, last time it was on Radiant, Universe could do a lot more. Even though he died once, he still got a lot of levels, and it was ultimately worth it for him. So this game, it might get shut down. I don't know if they're going to do a safe lane Puck. But Venomancer's still not bad here either. I mean, it's good against the heroes, but I don't think they're going to pick it up this game. What would be good? Maybe a Leshrac here. They have Lycan to deal with it. No, there's Mason's hero. They could go aggressive now. This is, they won't.
I agree. Just leaving. They seem to really be a fan of the dual lanes. Weaver, they're getting more direct physical damage. It's basically what we're getting into. Lycan is the melee hero, gets up front, has the critical, can lay down a lot of physical damage early on if you build him as such. Oh, well, hell, even when you build him the split push build, Necronomicon's still doing an amazing amount of physical damage thanks to Hal. So that's still going to be a lot of physical damage no matter what. Now, the Weaver being added into addition to that, I think that's some of the best mid-game physical damage dealers that you could possibly have. I mean, you could throw in, like, Templar Assassin remaining. And those kind of heroes to contest, but when it comes to good carries heroes that are also highly valued in the meta right now, Lycan and Weaver are kind of the top dogs. Reserve
time. Yeah, this is what EG, this is how they like to play. They like to play, all right, well, we'll just farm up our BKBs, get it on one or two heroes. Last game, they didn't need it on the Venomancer. So this game, they'll just get it on the Lycan and the Weaver, and then they're just going to run at you with their heroes and their aggressive playstyle. So if they can survive until they get their BKBs, Power Rangers might get overran. But we'll see how the... I mean, last game, they got split pushed to death on Power Rangers' side, and they had nothing to deal with that. Now they have a tree to deal with it. They have Ember, who can play really aggressive, can go all everywhere on the map, and they have Disruptor, so maybe this time they'll put out a lot more pressure instead of just waiting to be gone on.
Wraith King was banned away by Power Rangers, probably for the best, seeing as Wisp Wraith King seems to be a favorite of Evil Geniuses anyway. However, I'm feeling they need some sort of additional lockdown here, because the Puck by himself, if we have the BKB up on the gyrocopter, he's kind of going to be fine. He still has to deal with the Weaver and, of course, the Lycan's fast movement speed, but in general, I'm just feeling like they need a little bit of extra lockdown. I'm just not sure what's really left in the pool as far as supports they're going to be able to provide that. So, Doom now being picked up by Power Rangers, so they get themselves arguably one of the best counters to the Ember Spirit, but it's also going to be a strong hero up against any one of Evil Geniuses. Obviously, the Weaver and the Lycan. If you're able to catch out the Weaver without that Shukuchi, burn him down under that direct damage, or the Lycan before he can actually get the Shapeshift. Either one, Doom is going to be pretty powerful again. Now the Vengeful Spirit is going to be the last pickup from Evil Geniuses, so they mix in that direct physical damage with a direct stun and some minus armor to throw in.
Let's see, who's got the edge in this draft? Kind of curious. I think Power Rangers do, just because they can... just because the Doom last pick, I think it can shut down a lot of what EG do. So this time, Power Rangers, they can group up, and maybe they won't get picked off this time. Like I said, they just have a really good just split push EG lineup. Their capability to get relocates with the Puck initiates can set up a lot of ganks, but Power Rangers, as long as they just maybe 10 seconds group up as three or four, just go for these pickoffs. Doom is hard to kill. Ember Spirit's going to be hard to kill this game unless Puck goes on him. So they have a lot of ways to survive, but I don't know. I just want to see EG get punished for their greed, because it does look like a greedy lineup.
It does. At the same time, I do like the way that they drafted so much single-target physical damage up against the gyrocopter especially. Obviously, it's strong versus the Ember Spirit as well. I'm slightly concerned about their lack of lockdown for the Ember. Like you said, it's going to be all up to Puck pretty much in order to pick up a Blink Dagger and start getting those initiations on the Ember Spirit. But other than that, I think that even if you take away the Ember Spirit, take away that whole entire aspect, shutting down the gyrocopter with that kind of direct physical damage, I feel, is the best way to be able to counter him. Like, once he goes in the mid-game, he has a BKB. He's feeling kind of invincible, right? Because he's so strong. He's laying out both a good amount of magic damage as well as physical damage. He's got that amazing AoE ultimate as well. He's feeling good up until you get, like, a Desolator Weaver that starts beating into you, or just straight-up Arteezy could build into a very combat build for the Lycan, build something like a Armlet.
Yeah, I don't know what he's going to go this game. Armlet might be the choice. I don't know if rushing BKB is viable anymore on Lycan. Because you're against the Doom now.
Right.
So Doom can maybe shut him down. He might go back for the Necro books. I still think Weaver should just go BKB. He needs to go BKB into Desolator. Universe will most likely go for the... Well, he's got a Null Talisman this time around. So is he going to be playing offlane? Are they going to go safe lane with him? Yeah, I think they're, let's see, Acro mid lane. Tries,
so
yeah, it looks like.
Venge, yeah. Wisp, Weaver is, I mean, that's decently strong. And
yeah,
Power
you
Rangers,
just got to worry about the Leech Seed and the Boots first on the tree, although they don't know that.
Yeah, but as long as they don't get the supports, like the Weaver can play pretty far forward and not get caught out.
Right, and they can always just chase them. with the Wisp, the movement speed. Uh-huh. And then if they ever get in trouble, they can just use Magic Missile to get out. And then you also have the Howl coming on over the top. So top lane, Puck should win against the Doom. Mm-hmm. It'll be a Doom off lane. Depending on the creep he gets on the side lane, that could be a big factor in that. And mid lane, Arteezy, Ember Spirit against... No. This is a Gyro mid? Yeah, this is a Gyro mid. Holy cow. So it's not looking good for their bottom lane now at all.
No, really
Ember
isn't.
Ember Spirit.
Why do you think they don't place the Ember Spirit as in mid up against the Lycan? Earlier today, I did see a Lycan that
it's like Liquid, man. You watched like a long time ago. TC is the only person on that team that played Ember Spirit for the longest time. So they had to play it in the safe lane solo. Even though TC now was playing mid lane, they just didn't rotate it up. So it was just weird. So it's either a player thing or... it's just they think they're not going aggressive right now.
Oh, God. And Moon's going to get stunned up, and now he's dead. There's
the
just too much. Yeah, beautiful block by Mason. But I'm not even sure if that was necessary. PPD gets the first blood and will be rewarded probably with a fat set of boots for him. So just making this aggro try for Evil Geniuses even stronger.
Are they going to go aggressive? Is the question. They can still do dual lanes and be really effective as well. And J4 got scouted out, I'm pretty sure. So if he comes up, he didn't get scouted out. Because Wispwood went on them there.
Right. Yeah, I don't know. The Ember Spirit versus the Lycan is a fine matchup. I think the physical damage from the Lycan is a little bit troubling for the Ember Spirit at times. But I've still seen situations where Ember Spirit actually wins that matchup.
No, it's going to be a Gyro versus a Lycan. So
you're
I think,
right. I'm saying, but why do you think they don't put the Ember Spirit mid up against the Lycan?
Just because they think that they can get away with this Ember Spirit, and they would get out a lot more from these lanes. Like, Gyro can crush the Lycan, and then the Ember Spirit would be getting free farm. But since they're doing this aggro tri-lane, they're going to get owned in their laning phase, it seems like.
Well, PPD can grab boots right away if he wants to. And the support's now going to have to play really, really careful. You can see already, Moon is just sitting next to his tower, and they may, they're going to pick up J4 here. The Howl isn't there, but they should have enough movement speed between the Tether and Boots to pick up J4, even up against the Creep Wave. So, two kills very, very early for PPD, and who knows, this may be a guy who is able to pick up some early, like...
Oh, they're going to dive RTZ. Leech Seed level 1, he needs TP support. He's going to go down here. Oh, maybe FNG. Not tower aggro. Wow.
Just
that could have been first blood for them, but a little bit of misplay. I think Gyro should have just tanked the tower and then they could have de-aggroed it.
Yeah, RTZ also had the smart reaction there of running, hugging next to the cliff to try and stay out of range for the Leech Seed as long as humanly possible. So it looks like Power Rangers are actually going to lose every single lane here except for possibly the mid. Depending on what the rotations are going to be onto Scandal. Because you know it's going to happen eventually. They are going to go for the kill on J4 once again, but this time around, they're going to get caught. Zai has another tether here in just a second. He will be able to jump to PPD. Very smart decision by him. Separating the two of them, making them think that they got the kill on the Wisp, but tether comes up at the right time.
Right, and they're doing the roaming PPD strategy of the tree. But it's not going to be effective because they're not going to be able to kill the Puck, and they already missed their opportunity to kill RTZ middle, so it's all in vain right now for the laning stage for Power Rangers. But can they get back into this? I think they can. They still have a good lineup just to get back in this game. So at least they're winning on two CS fronts. Universe stomped up. Top lane.
Yeah, that's a big issue.
He's going to go down. Nice juke. 3-2-1. Nice phase shift.
Oh, and he keeps the health potion as well with that phase shift. You can actually maybe turn on Cheshire Cat there. He's got the big health lead, but decides against it. Probably because of the train protector. Just always a threat for him.
Yeah, the countdown was for the Scorched Earth. So once that ran out, for sure, no way to keep chasing. But mid lane, they're going to get... Scandal here. And yeah, this is what I was afraid down, of. But he won't.
The rotation from the supports, they already
Radiant
had such
Courier
a good
died
game.
Too in the mid lane.
Wow.
Uh-oh, this is getting out of control fast. Too.
Yeah, this is... Now they did lose all three lanes. Like, the Doom is doing okay versus the Puck, I guess, in that regard. But Puck is still going to be able to pick up a Blink Dagger, so I call that even. Mid lane has just been lost because Gyrocopter goes down from the rotations of the supports, and bottom lane has obviously been crushed pretty heavily.
Right. The one good thing is that Arteezy still doesn't have that much CS, and Gyro has a lot. And it wasn't first blood given, but the biggest problem was the courier kill with his bottle. So... Very unfortunate. They're going to go on Mason bottom lane, and he's going to get out.
They are going to be able to see him there with that last Thunderstrike. That's one of those unfortunate. Oh, my God. He's going to get the kill on Moon. Now he's actually going to health potion up. He's getting away. Moon. Oh, my God. Mason.
What a player. Top lane, though. They're going to go on. Nope. Nice reaction time.
That was clutch as hell. That was also the damage coming out from the Weaver. That
Man,
physical
the
damage
flame guard,
against an
number
Ember Spirit.
One, I thought it would have done more too. It was just, whew. Mid lane, RTZ. It was nice knowing you, buddy.
Are you sure he's? I think he's good. The Wolves are going to be able to block up for him a little bit. Yep,
nice
he's
blocking.
Good. Beautiful play. Now Scandal's going to be stunned up. RTZ turns, gets the kill. And actually, that's going to be FNG going down as well. Arteezy's going to pop his ultimate. He knows there's no Leech Seed. FNG can't kill him in time. And eventually, the stun.
Holy crit, too.
First take crit. And
let's see Mason do something amazing again.
Something amazing? Like, just right-click J4 down, chase him with Shukuchi, easy kill?
Yeah, easy just... life. He's going to... Yeah, he's about to kill him, too. I told you, man.
Yep.
Don't keep your eyes off this guy.
Oh, he has another Shukuchi. He can dive in deep here with the time lapse. He knows he can get this. Gets it. Time lapse out. Good. Mason
well, that's
reading
a
the lane 7
and
very 0, well.
5 minutes and 20 seconds in the game. You're not going to see any stronger of a performance than this right here.
Yeah, you really aren't. We also have Zai now coming in to the middle lane.
Moon, Dotten lane, Mason again. He doesn't have the... Uh-oh. Didn't have the Mason. Sakuchi. I'm at the Geminate.
Yeah. Jesus. What is Moon doing here?
Radiant's bottom tower is under...
I don't know why he's sticking around like that, like just to pick up his level 5. It was level 6, I can understand. It was level 6, you had mana for Remnants. You throw in the lane, you run back to base, Remnant back in, or something like that, but... That's just him being greedy.
Well, see, teams just focus on shutting down RTZ this game, and then the other team. Mason stepped his game up, Universe didn't die top, stepping his game, and the supports just made everything happen this game. So, you can't just shut down RTZ and expect to win this game, or any of the games. I mean, the whole EG lineup, just playing really well this game, and bottom lane... J4, your level 3.5 is going to go down.
Yeah, he's trying to hide himself. Throws out the glimpse, hiding himself in the corner, but he's still going to be caught out by the coil. Finally, he will take out there. As the rest of Evil Geniuses now going to focus on Moon, who's got no escape. And Jesus, the Howl Geminate attack is just ridiculous on that Weaver.
Yeah, and they TP'd into his death. They can't even get in a kill with Doom coming down here, too. Who has his Doom? This is just not looking good at all. Is this a shutout?
Yeah, that's what it feels like. If they do get a kill, it's probably not going to be a good exchange, at the very least. We already see, hey, why not? They rotated so many heroes down to the bottom lane. They knew they had a big advantage, and they're going to continue that advantage by now taking down this tier 1 tower. They're not going to lose anything for it.
Well, the one bad thing is now that they're so far behind, they can do some... easy Roshans once RTZ gets them, the Vlads. But they only got one tower against a tree. That's one thing to note. So it's not terrible for Power Rangers as long as they can get some levels. The biggest problem right now is their levels, and they just need to stop the bleeding. Find a way to just either group up or something.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Well, evil geniuses are going to do a little grouping up of their own. It's daytime, though. They're going to be spied out sitting on the other side of the cliff. Always an issue when you have those sort of problems. Nighttime to daytime, and all of a sudden your sneaky little gank is run afoul. Regen now being picked up by the Wiz. Zai is a little underleveled, but compare that to the other supports on Power Rangers. He's actually not that far behind. Attack.
And Mason just going to be right-clicking on the gyro middle lane. It's going to not be enough.
No, teleports away. So almost close. Was able to get him. Zai's immediate dead. Doom, though,
no.
Onto Zai.
The dream, the perfect game. It's gone.
Get the deny. Somebody get the deny. All right.
Does it count, though?
It doesn't count.
Does it count?
Well, on the scoreboard, it's there, but we're not going to count it, obviously.
All right, we're not counting it.
It's lame.
Yeah, we're not counting it. The dream is still real.
The dream is alive, gents. The dream is alive. J4 is going to go for a glimpse here into the kinetic field, knowing that Arteezy was going to be running out. Unfortunately, though, there's no mana or cooldown for Centaur Stun on Shishir Cat, and Arteezy simply teleports himself away.
And they're pressuring top lane. One good thing is that Moon is getting the catch-up farm he desperately needs, because Ember Spirit needs to be having a good start. But it's still going to be really hard for him. What can they... Well, Disruptor needs to go back to base and get some mana, because he's kind of useless. They need him to get level 6, and... Well, they just need Disruptor just to get some levels. That's their initiator, it feels like, right now.
Yeah, pick up early Static Storm to start shutting out the Weaver especially, but also the Puck as well is a fairly easy kill for you to get this early on. They wait much longer, though. Well, Moon may get picked off here. He's going to be jumping to his Remnant and should be fine, but he's also going to be cut off here. But it's just Zai, so it's not a big worry.
Well, Vlad's up now for Arteezy. Just going to be probably going into the jungle farming here. I mean, they can't pressure any towers. They want to wait a little bit. They need Wisp level 6. He's 5.5, and they want to wait for probably Universe's Blink Dagger. So before that happens, they should have done maybe a smoke gank with Doom with 3 of them, but it's just not happening. They're just kind of demoralized, it feels like, right now. Just don't know what to do. They're just sit back and farming when I think they need to be applying just a little bit of pressure. Just get one smoke gank every like 4 or 5 minutes. Try to get back in the board, or try to get on the board.
Yeah, because Evil Geniuses have picked up so many kills that you got some killing sprees available to you. They're also a higher level because of all the kills they've gotten, so that's a valuable experience that's left open in the field. You are going to see them do exactly that. The Doom is going to be placed onto the Weaver, and that should be a kill here. Zai is not level 6, unfortunately, or else he would actually be able to save the Weaver in that scenario. Zai was so close to 66 experience, and he would have had it. Gyrocops are going to throw down the ultimate here. May catch up PPD. Universe does a smart thing and teleports away, though. If only PPD had done the same, maybe they both would have lived.
Well, 2 dead. And Arteezy is going to be split pushing, but it's not useful, and he's going to get sent back here.
Oh, but he doesn't catch him out with the kinetic field, and with the ultimate going out, Arteezy is going to be fine.
Yeah, like we said, they got the kills top. Tree's level 6 now because of that. And EG, they're not going to be grouping up. They just like to split push, but this is one of those games where you kind of need to group up as EG. And Moon does have a remnant back here, but he's going to get caught out. Blink in 1, Moon's dead.
Yep, silence, combo. Well played by Universe. They really valued that Blink Dagger, and that's for a reason. Shutting out that Ember Spirit. The aggro try already did it well enough. Now that we start going into the mid game, it's going to get even better. Scandal. Yep. Oh, he was trying to block him out with the wolves, I think, but lost a little control of that micro. They're strong, but they can't be diving tier 1 towers just yet.
Yeah, they don't know that J4 has 0 mana, although he could get mana boots from FNG, but their top tower is getting pressured now for the Doom. Are they going to back, or are they going to pressure mid?
Double damage being popped, and RTZ says it's time to push down this tier 1 tower. Seen this before from Evil Genius, or maybe go back and do Roshan? there's no real reason for all of them to back away from that tower except in this direction to do Roshan. So they feel confident enough to be able to do it right under Power Ranger's nose. Like, it should be very obvious to PR. They're going to come in. They do have some good scouting ultimates here. Like, FNG, if he catches them out with an Overgrowth mixed in with a lot of the AoE damage, he gets the Overgrowth. He just barely snagged by Arteezy in time. Moon comes in, Static Storm, and look at that AoE damage. Three heroes are going to drop in the process. There was the relocate from the Zai, but he was unable to get the tether because of the Static Storm, so he was actually silenced up. Doom was able to finish off the Weaver on the side as well, so Cheshire Cat gets the solo experience for that one. So they get three hero kills, and they actually force out the Aegis away from Arteezy. Actually, that was four hero kills, because they got the Vengeful Spirit as well.
Yeah, it just shows you that their team fight is amazing. It's just that they gave up such an early game debacle.
Just imagine if that Overgrowth had come in just a half a second sooner.
Yeah.
Might have been able to snag Roshan for themselves, also get that Aegis.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Well, they got a tier one out of it, so that's nice. They needed that after that. I'm just curious to see, like you said, what is Arteezy going to go for? Is he going to go for the Necro, the BKB? What does he get? But we saw Mason go back for a Midas, pretty late Midas. And I think if they're just going to be determined to try and go late game with this, they're just going to have to keep trying to split push, split pick off. If they go for these kills top lane, I mean, they're going to get picked off by Disruptor here. So nice of them to back off.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Yeah, J4 was still only level 3 Glimpse. Not having the pick off potential that he really should at 15 minutes in. But he's almost there. Just one more creep, he'll have level 7. Maxed out Glimpse now available to him. Ember Spirit maxed out his Searing Chains early on. You see some Ember Spirits do this when they want to be really aggressive and get the most out of the damage from their Q. He's going for the Phase Boots Drums build. He knows he has to be a fighter here. He can't just sit AFK farm up a Battle Fury.
Dire's top tower is
They have a lot of kind of cores already too. So they have Gyrocopter, they have Doom. As long as they weather the storm, they have a really good late game. Because Doom is going to be shutting down somebody, Ember Spirit with the Turtle, and you also have the Gyro for the Turtle. So right now, you could say that EG drafted a really great lineup, but so did Power Rangers, but their just team fight is really, it's kind of superb, it feels like. Whereas EG, they're just like, all right, we're going to try to pick you off one by one. But I don't think they can do that unless they have the BKBs and the heroes, like I said.
Evil Geniuses gonna back themselves away. Again, just continue the split push. You said it best. Evil Geniuses just like to split push, get greedy, get farm up on all their heroes. There's no sense in them trying to force themselves into this team fight of Power Rangers when it's so damn good. We saw the power of it inside that Roche pit. It's just unlikely they're gonna have another scenario where the enemy team is stuck in a small little box like that.
Right. Well, I mean, this tree is just doing too much work this game right now. If they didn't have this tree, I think they would have lost the game. Probably right by at this mark. Just because EG, they love split pushing. They love split pushing. And what counters that is this tree, Living Armor. So
it really is, and every bit of chip damage is permanent now. Double damage from Gyrocopter will ensure the tier 1 tower does go down. Evil Geniuses just content to continue to farm, and it looks like he's going to be going for your suggestion of BKB. Even though you actually did say that he shouldn't be going at this time around.
No,
right?
I said he should.
Oh, he should.
He should. Like, him and Mason both need BKB. If they don't get BKBs, they're useless in these team fights. I said it would be, I would be shocked that he goes it, kind of, because you have the Doom to shut him down. But as long as you can get your shapeshift off, then BKB, you're golden, even if you get doomed. So I think it's a really good item still on Arteezy. And he realizes it too. It just depends on what Mason's going to do.
Well, Mason's got another 2K gold, so he's going to have to make a decision soon. The Adventures of Arteezy's Eye. Well, they actually almost have a mech full up on the Wisp. Big upgrade for him. BKB and just another 1,700 gold or so for Arteezy. See a rotation to the top lane. Doom is already down below half health. Fortunately, he does have a Blink Dagger. That Blink Dagger is going to be pretty necessary up against the Weaver. It's one of those unfortunate scenarios where the Weaver wants a Lincoln's because of Doom, but at the same time wants a BKB because of Static Storm and all the other AoE.
Yeah, because Power Rangers have such a greedy lineup where they have three cores farming, they kind of have to split up and just try and farm all the time. So that's kind of unfortunate for them. They're not grouping up as much, but right now they might pick off the... They got a good vision here, so good overgrowth. They're going to catch out. Universe. Oh, the Blink Dagger. Very unfortunate.
Universe has the orb, and they won't be able to give him a glimpse back, though, and Universe will still fall in the end. The attempt at a relocate away from Zai, he just couldn't get the tether. As Puck came back, it's a little disorienting. First, he was down here, then he was here, and then he was also phase-shifting. Zai's going to be slowed down. He does have a tether, but the creep wave isn't in wave just yet. Now finally jumps to it. And will be able to get himself... Oh,
another glint up. Holy cow, this is so imbalanced.
What an anti-climactic glint that is. Zai tries to teleport away, but all he just ends up doing is wasting 135 gold. Top lane is being pushed in, but the tier 1 tower is still kept alive thanks to that living armor.
Yeah. Right as I say, they don't group up. They group up. So... really well played there, getting two kills. They're not going to get this tower, and Moon needs to play a little bit careful here. Universe is smoked up. Nay, who died?
Mason. Oh, yeah. Looks like he died as Cheshire Cat comes over with the Doom. Showed off that fancy Blink Dagger.
Full beat. I thought they were going to relocate Moon, but they didn't. I don't know, man. Power Rangers, just as long as they can keep holding out, they have the better late game, it feels. They have the better heroes, so...
Their late game is super... I feel their late game is pretty risky, though.
Not really. Doom shuts down a hero. Ember Spirit owns. And Gyrocopter is about to have a butterfly. So they have a tri-core.
Yeah, I didn't really think about the Doom. For me, I was just looking at the Ember Spirit and Gyrocopter, but you're right. I forgot about that third core that I really wasn't taking account of. For me, I was just like so focused on the fact that Ember Spirit can be easily shut down if focused, and same goes with the Gyrocopter, because eventually, once we start getting into like BKB Butterfly, Gyrocopter is actually going straight for a Butterfly, by the way. So, no BKB for him, and it makes sense.
I just said that. Gosh, don't listen to me at all.
Whatever, man. Whatever, man. Yule Scepter is going to be picked up soon by Universe. Did you say that?
Nope.
Yeah, that's right. You didn't, did you? Because you're new.
Because I wanted you to do it.
You wanted a chance to make me look smart or say something.
Yeah, you smart.
Smart man.
Not as smart as Universe. He's gone.
Glimpse stopping the teleport away. Now he's going to be chained up. Chain. Oh, he already used it. He already used it on the creep wave. He's going to have to slide a fist here. Chase with the remnants. Oh, Universe. You bugger you. He's going to turn around and kill the Disruptor. He does die as Moon kills him.
Oh, top Zai's going to go down.
That was clutch as hell. Another Doom being used. Yep. Another Doom being used.
All right. That was a pretty heads up play by Universe.
That was damn heads up. And Mason is going to be going for the... Lincoln's, thank you. Yeah, that thing.
It's kind of useless in my opinion. I mean, it stops the Disruptor, but it's still not going to stop the Doom because he has a blink. He can easily level death and Doom you before you do anything. So it's not really that great. And if he's getting the Lincoln Sphere, he's going to have to go for damage afterwards. So he's going to have to get a Desolator and... in which case, he's going to be still even more vulnerable. Well, I guess if you could get a BKB on the Weaver, you could pop the BKB, and then the only thing that goes through it is the Doom.
Arteezy just casually farming up the enemy jungle, now going to work his way into Roshan once again, doing a right under Power Ranger's nose. I mean, they had vision of Arteezy making his way through here. They should have an idea that, you know, Roshan is up about this time, but they had to immediately check. The physical damage is too quick in coming from Evil Geniuses.
Right. They got a really good team fight last time from the Rosh Pit too, and Mason doomed and he's gone. Wow, that is so lucky. so Dire's lucky.
Tower is under attack. The fact that he gets off the Shikuchi at the same time the Doom goes out?
Yes.
Yeah.
Very, very lucky. Should I say it one more time? No, I'm just kidding. He's going to have his Lincoln Sphere, though, soon.
And that.
The level death, it's not good enough.
I was looking for him to blink, hit his stun during the small time that Shikuchi is down, hit the centaur stun, follow up level death. Still don't think it was going to be enough, though.
What do you... Let's see. All right. Battle Fury is almost complete on Ember Spirit. Now that I think EG are feeling the pressure. So they have the relocate up. They have the Lincoln Sphere. They have the go time, and here it is.
Evil Geniuses are going to get caught out by the Static Storm. Catches them both. Arteezy is going to be making his way in with the BKB. Immediately starts focusing on Scandal, but he's got a butterfly. He's not doing any damage to Arteezy, or to Scandal. He's just walking away. Arteezy's now going to be caught out. Moon, he's got a sleight of fist. It's not quite enough. The level death, though, secures the kill, and they're going to be able to pick up the second one as well. So Arteezy's going to be surrounded. He's got no shapeshift. Used it in the first life. And three hero kills in exchange for a disruptor. Really good setup there for Power Rangers. Very fortunate Static Storm kinetic field combo. They caught out both of those key heroes. The Vengeful Spirit as well as the
no initiation from Universe. He gets counter initiated on. They lose a fight pretty easily there. So it's very unfortunate. Butterfly, like you said, did too much work in that fight. So now it's just looking like it's on the clock now. It looks like we thought this game could go the way of EG really fast, but now it's just looking like there's no way Power Rangers can lose.
Yeah, with that one fight, Power Rangers actually managed to get themselves back up into a gold advantage over Evil Geniuses and had leading in experience. So they now have a Battle Fury up for Moon. I didn't think I was ever going to see that, but he's picked up a Battle Fury. So the transition into the carry Ember Spirit that is really tough to push into. And that's a big problem for Evil Geniuses because they have all this physical damage, but the split push is just being trashed by the Terrain Protector. It's kind of poetic justice to see Evil Geniuses have such a hard time against one of the heroes they have made so popular in the recent meta, which is that tree.
Right. They are losing this game because of tree. It's sad to say, but I mean, there's nothing else you can chalk it up to.
Run, buddy. You've been spotted. May need to blink away. Arteezy didn't even care. He's trying to finish up his Assault Cuirass. MKB is going to be necessary as the next item for Mason in order to deal with this Gyrocopter. Somebody's got to be able to lay down that physical damage, and it's... Considering the butterfly, but also the number of misses he had, thanks to that butterfly, was just insane. So obviously, good clutch play there from Zai. Coming in, Cheshire Cat tried to actually intercept it there with the level death to stop the relocate. Universe is positioning himself. They want to actually take this fight. This is crazy, but they know they're going to be severely grouped up. Oh no, he got caught by the Static Storm as well as the Overgrowth, and now they're all going to fall. Centaur Stun goes out, ensures the kill on Mason even as the Silence fall, and Universe gets a Doom on him, and I think he's actually going to die from that one, especially with the level death from Cheshire Cat. Power Rangers are now in a position to be able to take down the Tier 2s, possibly push into a Tier 3. And Arteezy can do nothing but just continue to farm and go, well, you guys, you done messed up. You done messed up in that last team fight. I can't believe they tried to force that. But also Universe making a very uncharacteristic mistake there and running into the Static Storm.
Yeah, they would need Universe to go on the Disruptor. If they're not shutting down the Disruptor in these team fights, they're going to lose every single time. They lost the last two team fights because of the Disruptor and Tree. And it's just... It's going to be the story of why they lost this game, it feels. They needed a gem down here in their jungle because they got caught out, and then they needed to find a way to shut down the Disruptor. So when they didn't, they immediately lost all these both team fights, and now, like I said, it's on the clock now. How does Power Rangers... I kind of want to say throw this game because... Arteezy's just going to need like six items and he's just going to have to one-shot everybody.
Centaur stun onto Arteezy, going to force out the shapeshift, but nothing too special out of that one. If Cheshire Cat had a Doom, maybe he would have been able to Doom him up and with the Shiva slow and everything else, keep up in range for some extra support. But without the Doom, Arteezy's just able to shapeshift away. Still working on that AC. What else do we got on the board here for Evil Geniuses? I can't believe it. Just felt like EG were controlling this game for so long, but I think you identified the issue much better than I ever did, which was they weren't able to push in. Like, when you said that, I was like, yeah, but they're still winning the game hard enough. But you're right. With, like, a Tier 1 tower still up at that top lane, they just haven't been able to take the towers they needed to. They're going to try and catch out Moon, but unsuccessful in doing so. They don't have the disables to be able to hold them in. So once he actually becomes a credible threat, he's not going to be easy to shut down whatsoever.
I just don't know. They're going to need Sheepstick on Universe, Abyssal Blade on RTZ.
Yep.
And even then, he still needs an MKB. So right now, they're just lacking a lot. They're going to have to take this at least another 40, 50 minutes. And then expect to win these team fights, which they've been losing.
Cheshire Cat. He's going to pop the Shiva, slowing down some of these heroes. We'll make sure he gets the Frost, and he's actually going to turn on this. Double stun comes out, and now the Gyrocopter making his way in. Flag cannon shots are going to be able to finish off Zai on the side. Good use of the Yule Scepter in order to free up Arteezy to chase out Cheshire Cat. Cheshire Cat's trying to blink away. Get the jukes. Not going to make it. Arteezy gets that one last strike to ensure the kill. Scandal's willing to take this fight, though. I'm surprised. What? Both of them are going to teleport in front of each other. And the smileys. That was one of the oddest scenarios I've ever seen in my life, I think.
But gentlemen's agreement.
Gentlemen's agreement. Well, they also had no way to stop each other.
Dire's top tower.
Right. Aggressive players. Yeah. That's true. Honestly, I was a little bit surprised Scandal was willing to try and take that 1v2 up against a double damage, even if he does have the butterfly, but... apparently he wasn't. He's gonna have an MKB soon. For the gyro.
He has no HP, and yet he can get away with it too. It's just so disgusting right now. They have nothing to deal with him. It's just not enough. Well, now what can they do? All right, like I said, that's good. They try to get a pick off there from EG, but. So no, it was a trade-off, and I don't know.
They need the MKB finished by Weaver.
They need a lot of pickoffs. Just keep saying a lot of pickoffs. We'll go with that.
Yeah.
RT's going to get picked off here.
Mason is going to be spotted out. He could use the Overgrowth here. Pops the Linkage. Now gets the over. Oh, but good use of the Yules there from Universe. Smart decision. Now he's going to actually try and finish up this support. Universe jumps to an odd angle on the side. Mason's being chased down, but the ultimate's not going to be enough. Top lane. They are going to be able to get the kill on PPD on the side. Zai comes back in with a relocate and teleports himself out. Scandal still working on trying to finish off Mason, but Mason has just a little bit too much to get away. And looks like they did get the puck as J4 came in from the side and laid down that static storm to hold Universe in place.
And Arteezy was doomed. They relocated out, so nicely played by Zai, but still, there's just nothing they can do. This game is just way too far. It's just way too far gone. I just can't see them way in the back in the game. I just don't like calling games, but I'm trying to figure a way out from the back.
Well, it's
going
to get
BKB.
Even worse when Arteezy, he doesn't pop the BKB in time. He's still going to be able to get out, though. Zai may not be as lucky as a tether, needs to jump to somebody, but it's the BKB use of the wolf, though. Very smart decision. Good coordination there from Zai as well as Arteezy, recognizing the problem and rectifying it pretty quickly. Tier 2 tower is going to fall, though. Power Rangers, they may not have gotten the pickoff, but they now have some big item pickoffs. They now have the double Battle Fury for the Ember Spirit, so for me, that's when the physical damage Ember Spirit becomes a real threat. We also have Doom, who's going to be able to finish up an Assault Cuirass, so throwing in some Minus Armor with all those AoE physical damage attacks, whether it's the Sleight of Fist or the Gyrocopter Flat Cannon, either one. The AC is going to massively benefit them, and they also have the MKB for the Gyro.
Roshan is going to be coming up here in 20, 30 seconds. So they have Images. It's going to scout it out too, so they're going to do that most likely on Power Rangers. It's going to come down to this Roshan. EG is going to have to contest, and I don't know if they can still win that team fight without the Abyssal Blade, the MKBs that are required on the course.
So I'm thinking Scandal goes to Satanic next, just to make sure that he can't really be picked off. If he gets a little unlucky or focused down from any sort of magic damage, PPD is going to try and teleport away, but there's too much damage from Power Rangers on the side. They're going to be able to catch out the Disruptor as well as FNG, quickly killing him. Cheshire Cat is silenced up before he can get a good stun. Universe comes back into play, but I don't think he's going to be able to blink out the damage. Oh, Jesus. One shot from Gyrocopter wipes out the puck. The rest of EG were able to get themselves away, but a 2-for-2 trade, 2 supports in exchange for a support in offlane. Power Rangers still looking strong.
Yep, Scandal can do whatever he wants. They can't even touch him without a sheep stick or an abyssal. He can just go run at them 1v5 and they really can't do anything.
Mason did still go for the BKB, which means he's going to be severely lacking in damage.
He needed that the first item. Like, I told him. He didn't listen. Gosh. Dang it, Mason. Not listening. It's still... It's just they were on a timer this game, and they missed their timings. So, very unlucky. And it's just good play by Power Rangers, it feels like, instead of EG throwing or anything. So,
well, they still have a chance here with... The potential Abyssal pickup would be my next item of choice. I know he's going to need MKB eventually, but for now, I think just trying to get a little lucky with those bashes and hoping Gyro's a little unlucky with the misses, I think is going to be your best hope, especially if you can actually get the full-on Abyssal and have that straight lockdown. Moon is going to force out the shapeshift and get himself away. That's the big issue. Again, it's only the puck that should really be able to catch out the Ember Spirit. Moon should always be able to dodge that magic missile and get himself away.
Right. No lockdown for Gyro, no lockdown for Ember Spirit. I mean, these carries, they can do whatever they want in these team fights. And they're going to get Roshan right here. So, is this the Cheese 2? Yep. Cheese 2. Gun will go the way of Power Rangers. So, I mean, Gyro, he can even go, like you said, he's probably going to go Satanic. I would like to see a... What is that called? A Divine? I think that's what it's called. It was last game.
Yeah,
last
it was.
Last game we got Divine.
And they won with it too, but... this time that's around, it will be...
That's called stat padding right
there. It will be a Satanic.
No, that's how you stat pad.
Uh-huh.
So, that's how you get Nahas to freak out. 100% win rate on Weaver with... Divine Rapier.
Is that how you also have 100% loss rate with Flying Courier on the Huskar?
Yeah. Well, J4 is going to get picked off. 100%
Something
loss
small.
With Capitalist on my team.
Well, that ain't true.
it's inaccurate.
You got some bad data there, friend. Stunned up on Moon. Oh, jumps away with the Remnant. Once again, nothing they can do about that. Maybe they can kill FNG. Do they have vision? If he can Nature's Guys, they don't actually have vision. FNG just Nature Guys. Now they have nothing to be able to do against him. Silence, something small goes out, but he's still going to be just fine. And they're actually really grouped together here. The Battle Fury hits are going to be real here. Zai comes in an attempt to save him, but he's just adding more splash damage up against the Sleight of Fist. Arteez is going to pop his BKB. Zai's still trying to get away. It looks like he was trying to come in with the relocate, but it got canceled. Arteez is still chasing down Moon, but it's just made just getting kited around. And he's going to get blown up. So three heroes go down. Power Rangers lose nobody, not even close. And now just going to fight mad through top. Nothing should be stopping them from ending this game and pushing this to a game 3.
Well, I think going into the next game, you just have to either ban the tree or you just pick a better 5-man lineup. Or maybe even, I think the biggest problem this game was maybe the Doom pickup at the end. Also, the Disruptor caused a lot of havoc. But I think in the end, what EG likes to do, like I said, split pushing, you just have to ban out the tree.
Agreed. I totally agree, man. I've been calling it for a little while now. Just take away the tree. I'm tired of seeing him. Please. Universe is going to jump in. Something small onto Scandal, but he does have that Satanic, even if he does go low. Oh, BKB being used by the Weaver and the time lapse with the swap. Awkward positioning. Bad synergy between the two. And that means they're both kind of in a bad position there. Moon is actually being targeted pretty heavily here by Mason, but is still able to jump himself away. Universe did get a double coil in the background. Scandal still trying to fight up against multiple carries here on the side. Arteezy, though, was held in place long enough, and Arteezy will be the player to call the GG. 28-17, 37 and a half minutes in. And Power Rangers. Don't think many people would have betted their rares on just this single game going the way of PR, but they do manage to push Evil Geniuses to a Game 3 in the semifinals of the ESL 1, the Dota 2 Champions League Season 3 playoffs.
ESL, baby.
That too. Thoughts, Ryu?
I already beat it to death. I don't want to beat it to death anymore. Yeah. Third game, just, we'll see. Maybe East server?
Well, considering PPD rage quit a cast over USD server being used, that'd be some major hypocrite action. So I'm sure that's not going to happen. Power Rangers versus Evil Geniuses, Game 3 coming up in just a few minutes.